Hello and welcome to the physics lab. I hope you enjoy today's lab because today we are going to study nuclear science. The first thing you will need is one of these from this box.
Behind you. Oh, they're gone. Okay.
First thing you're going to need for today's lab is diffraction grating. They come in little boxes like this. If you open them up, they tell you, this is very important, so pay attention. It tells you that, for example, this one says it has 15,000 lines per inch. It lies. You also see a number here, 1. Trust me, it's on there. Okay? The 1 is much more important than the 15,000 lines per inch. Because when you come to me, what you do is you say, Matt, I've got number 1. And I will look at my cheat sheet and I'll say, number 1 has 12,744 lines per inch, not 15,000. I have my little cheat sheet here that gives me all that information. So make sure you get that one and don't use the one that's written on there. Now, so you've got the number of lines per inch. Well, that's useful to nobody because we don't do things in lines per inch. What do we do things in? We don't use inches.
We use real units.
Like what?
Meters.
Meters. Furlongs. That's an eighth of a mile. No.
How many furlongs to a meter?
3,742. Actually, no, that's how many meters per... I don't know. It's an eighth of a mile. So, if I give you the number of lines per inch, how do we convert that to something useful like lines per meter, which is what we're going to need? All right. Well, I know that 1 inch is 25.4 millimeters. The inches cancel. And I know that there's 1,000 millimeters in 1 meter. The millimeters cancel. So now if I multiply this out, 1,000 divided by 25.4 times the number you're given, you will get the lines in meters. You are going to need to know how to do that. Another thing I know is that today in class, these were bad people. All right. So that's before you even do anything, you gotta know all that. So how do we do this lab? Well, let's go over to the lab and find out. Connor, can you tell us about this lab? Why are you in this lab?
Well, I'm here, Matt, because I can't make it next week. I'm here to do it today to help you guys figure this out.
Isn't that special? All right, so actually, he's already done it, and we just did it for practice. And then, as for letting him do it early and suffering through it, he's also agreed to make this video. So what do you need for this lab? Well, you'll need this. I bet you remember one of these from grade school where you had to make some kind of presentation, right? Now Jake, our guest cameraman, had to step away because he's laughing so hard. He's pretty useless anyway. You will need one of these guys here. Now, when you see it, it won't have the lamp in here. Why? Because we store those separately in nice, safe boxes. Like this. Or maybe like this. Okay? Be very careful with them because they are made out of glass. Glass, when you drop it, breaks. Oh crap, that was the one that still had the bulb in it.
Didn't sound like it.
Nah, it doesn't. But Connor thought it was. All right, so you have to plug this in, and when you turn it on, it makes this really weird looking light. See? Not normal. Not normal at all. What?
Okay. It hypnotizes you.
Some people are easily hypnotized. You may need this jack stand, or maybe not. I don't think you actually do. We'll see. All right. So then, move the camera. Move the camera behind here. So. What you're also going to need is a bunch of other things. You're going to need two lens holders. This is one lens holder. It's already got the diffraction grating in it. You're going to need these Teflon pieces. There's three of them. By three, I mean four. Right here.
Here.
See? And we've clamped them onto this meter stick. Okay? So they're going to, when you get them, they're not actually going to be on there. They're going to be off of it, like this. You have to put them on here. The bottom ones, it doesn't matter where you put them. They are just for support. And what you do is you put this guy here, the other lens holder, a distance L away from the diffraction grating. What is the distance L? Well, you get to choose that. How about that? I would choose something, you know, nice and normal, like 50 or 60 centimeters, something like that. Anything else and you're going to make your life miserable. And I don't want you to make your life miserable because I don't want to miss the opportunity. Come on. Jeez. You're also going to need one of these things here. This looks like a piece of plastic. You know why?
Because it is.
Because it's a piece of plastic. When you get it, it won't have this tape on here. You have to put two pieces of tape on here to make a nice little slit. See this piece of slit?
Yes.
All right. It's right there. See, I can see you. Peekaboo. All right. You make that about a 32nd of an inch wide. That's about a millimeter for those of you who don't know the English units. There are two kinds of countries in this world. Those who use metric units and those who have been to the moon. All right. And that's going to go in here like this. Now be careful when you're doing this because if you let go and your fingers are in the middle, it's really going to hurt like hell. So let your lab partner do it. All right. And that's about 50 centimeters. Now, what I'm going to show you on this, I haven't made up the spreadsheet for it, but we do have three sets of documents that are going to be combined to make the spreadsheet. So, let's take a look at it. First of all, we're going to write in our diffraction grating, lines per inch. That's the one you get from me. In this case, he's got number 2, and I told him from the spreadsheet there that it's 12,661. He's figured it out in terms of lines per millimeter and lines per meter. All right? You only need really the lines per meter, so when you come to the spreadsheet that I actually make up, I may have skipped some of those, like the lines per millimeter. Then from that, he figures out D. Connor, how did you figure out D?
Well, it's quite simple, Matt. You just take this value right here, and you have 1 divided by this value.
So it's just the reciprocal of the lines per meter. It's the meters per line. It should be a small number, like 2 times 10 to the negative 6. If you get a large number, that's probably a really bad sign, isn't it, Connor?
Yes, it is, Matt.
What would happen if you did that?
You would have to redo the whole lab.
Because?
Because you screwed up with your calculations.
Yes. Do you have any experience with that?
Yes, I do, Matt.
All right.
Multiple times.
Okay. So then he put down his L. He's got it set up at 50 centimeters, so 0.5 meters. And then when he listed his M value, and we're not talking James Bond here, is the number 1, which is not 2 or 0. All right. So then, and again, this will probably look different on your spreadsheet when we get here, when you're there. He's figured out all his thetas in radians. Now, how do you figure out the theta in radians? Well, this will be in the manual, but what it essentially is that D times the sine of theta is equal to m times lambda. So d sine theta divided by m is 1 anyway, so it doesn't matter, is lambda. So all you have to do is take the arc sine, and you'll get the angle. And your angles here, for example, in his case, he's figuring out the wavelengths. And don't worry about why you're doing this. That's in the manual. 300 nanometers up to 700 nanometers. And his angle in radians goes from about 0.15 to about 0.35. Check that before you ask me what's wrong with your data. If you don't have that kind of range, if it's something like 12 to 27, you've got a problem. That's in radians. Now, if you do it in degrees, it goes from a minimum of about 8 to a maximum of about 20. Again, we'll go over why we're doing this in a little while. This is the logistics of the whole thing. So here we have it from, we went from radians to degrees. Now we're going to calculate why. Why? Because I said so! Now, why? What we're doing here actually is we're figuring out where each of the wavelengths are going to be on this. And we want y in meters. So what we do is all we have to do for this one here is this is just straight trigonometry. The tangent of this angle here, theta, that's the angle theta, is equal to the opposite over the adjacent. The adjacent is L. The opposite is the length. So we just use that. Tangent of the theta in radians. Remember, Excel uses radians. Tangent of theta times L will give you this distance here for each of these wavelengths. But they're wrong, and we'll see why it's wrong in a minute. All right. Now we've got it in meters, and we're going to translate that to centimeters. Why? Because we want it in both. All right. Then we're going to subtract the distance of the first one, and this is all done automatically for you, so don't worry about it too much. Because we only are interested in the distance from 300, we're going to put 300 right about here. So when we print out our scale, which we'll do soon, it's going to start at 300. So we have to subtract off the distance from 300 so we get a good scale. Okay. All that's done for you. So now, we're done, right? Oh, no, we got a lot to do. Okay, next thing is we gotta ask, by the way, Connor.
Yes, Matt?
I thought you said your girlfriend was gonna be in this video. Where is she?
She's not here.
I'm beginning to think she doesn't exist. You got an invisible girlfriend, don't you? I mean, you said you were gonna go out and have lunch with her, but when I went out there, it was just you out there. And then you came in and said she'd already left. I think you got yourself an invisible girlfriend.
Well, that's what you can think, Matt.
Yes, it is. All right, well, we'll have to see about that. Okay, so how do we print out the chart and scale? This is pretty easy. Why don't you show us how to print out the chart and scale, Connor?
Well, you go to...
That's a deep subject.
Right here, and you have the chart right here.
He went on the chart and scale page on the Excel spreadsheet.
Make sure you select this scale. You
want to go All right.
File.
In.
And then you hit print, and then you look... See that right here? You can see the whole chart.
And you hit print. Don't do it. Oh, well. And here it is. Amazing, isn't it? This is also another lab. Another name for this lab is the tree killing lab. Okay. One of the important things you do before you print this out, because as you may have realized, there are other people that are going to be printing this out all at the same time. And if you don't put anything to identify yours, you might pick up somebody else's. Like, I got this guy Connor's in Rachel. Man, that's awful looking. Piece of crap. All right, and there's a reason that one's a piece of crap too, by the way, but you know that. That one's actually a good one. This one's the piece of crap. So what you want to do is you want to put your name here on the top. You can put anything you want, as long as it's something that identifies you, because it's not going to matter, because we're going to cut it off here. Then what we're going to do here is we're going to take a look at this thing. They cut it all up. All right, so one thing that you're going to need is some scissors. And the scissors are out at the front. Now, here's very important to make your lab partner run around with the scissors. By the way, Connor, these are not scissors. This is glue. Go sniff it or something. I don't know. He's been sniffing glue. The scissors are at the front, over by my sunglasses.
They're next to the cookies.
Next to the cookies, yes. Yes. No, you're not. Okay, so he cut it off. You don't need this right away. But what you have to do is you have to measure the distance between the first line and the last line with a ruler. All right? And you measure that in centimeters. And I got 19.7. Then you go back. our guest cameraman is, yeah. Jake is left.
Left in the bin. I got him to tripod, so I win.
All right. So it's 19.7 centimeters from the first line going up here to the last line. Not to the axis edge, but to the last line. This represents 300 nanometers, and this represents 700 nanometers. Okay? So I put that in back on the same spreadsheet here. I put in 19.7. All right? Once I do that, see if I leave it off. Garbage. Once I put in 19.7, it's going to tell me a number. In this case, 56.11. Round it to the nearest integer. In this case, 56. And now you have to kill another tree. Because you have to reprint your plot. So you go back here to File. Now watch this very carefully. You might want to take notes. Hit Print. And then you go to Page Setup, all the way at the bottom. Page Setup. And then you go to Options. And on Effects, the tab Effects, you will see percent of normal size. You type in this case, 56. Your mileage may vary. All right? And you hit OK. And you get this. It's a smaller version of the original. See? Now what do you do with this? Now is where you do the part where you run with scissors. No. Now, what you were going to do is you take this out, and you are going to glue yours. First of all, cut it out, and then you glue it onto here. Now you may say, Matt, that's amazing. How did you make it just stick there like that? Well, it's because I put the glue on already. All right? And you'll see on here a little line, and you're not going to be able to see it on the video, but there's a little line right here, and that's supposed to line up with your beginning of your y-axis. Now you might say, man, we've done a lot of work here, and we don't have any data yet. You're right, we don't. So we put that on there, and what we have done is we have built our very own spectrometer. Pretty damn cool, isn't it? All right, so now we want to line this up with our light. Turn our light on, it's on. Make sure we can see it through here, which I can't, because it's off. That's terrible, but it's okay. You can't see it anyways, so we'll just pretend. All right. So if I got this right, which I know, it might take some adjustment. There we go. So you do some adjustment. Probably call me over to ask me what the hell's wrong with you.
Many times.
Many times. Don't see anything. Then after a while I say, hey Greg, you see why I can't see anything on here? So Greg comes over. He's much better at this than I am.
Line it up with the light, and in the dark.
Stay away from the light.
Because you're getting all the...
Oh, yes, we turn the lights off. That helps, too.
But all the lines you're seeing are from the mercury on top.
Oh, very true, very true. So, we turn the lights off. You go turn the lights off quickly.
Doesn't make it good for videotapes, though.
Yeah, let's not do that. All right, we're going to pretend the lights are off. And what you do is when you look through here, you're going to see lines with colors like red and cyan and blue and I can't remember what the one. Purple, that's it. All right. And what you do is you take out your pen. Actually, I don't have a pen, so I'll use this in here, pretending. And you mark it on here where you see them by looking through here, and you mark one for the red. Oh, I see a red one there. It's right there. I can actually see it now. You mark that one. Hey, that's not in the same spot you're marked on yours. I think you got bad data there, Con.
Yep.
You should ask your invisible girlfriend for help.
Maybe next time.
She's supposed to be much smarter than he is, but then again, you know. How hard can that be? And I see the blue one, too. So you mark the blue one, you mark the red one, you mark the cyan one, and you mark the violet one. Remember, violence is... Violet is never the answer. All right. So, and you use this glue here, by the way. You don't sniff it. Just use this. Let me... anyway, so you mark those all. Now you take this off. Actually, you leave it on. I'm wrong. You take this thing off. Hey, Greg, no eating in the lab.
I'm not eating.
Oh, you're not eating. Okay.
I'm just stealing them so I can eat them later.
Oh, okay. Let's make sure. And you measure the distance from the center of the slit to each of your lines. And there's going to be a nice spreadsheet which doesn't exist right now. All right? So for example, to our red line it says it's 19 or 18.6 centimeters. Now we have another triangle. And let's write this up on the board here. We know on this side it's 50 centimeters. We know on this side it's 18.6 centimeters. This is to the red line. So what we want to do is we want to figure out this angle here. Tangent of theta is equal to 18.6 over 50. Easy, right? So we can figure out our tangent of theta, we can figure out our theta. It's the arctangent. Remember, we're using Excel. In Excel, all the angles are in
radians.
Radians, not degrees. Why? Ask Bill Gates. Don't ask me. All right. So now we have our thetas. We have our thetas. You do that for each of the colors that you see. There should be four of them. And I mean four, not three, four. The blue and cyan are hard to tell apart. Trust me, you'll see them if you work at it. Right, Connor?
Right.
He did see them. He saw the light.
I did.
It opened up his eyes.
And I saw.
Yeah. So I saw the sign. Okay, I know this is a long video, but trust me, it'll be a lot quicker if you pay attention to all this. Okay, so you got your angles. Now, how do we get from angles to energy? Well, there's an equation. Actually, first we have to get to wavelength. Back to wavelength. And we know that lambda is equal to d times the sine of theta divided by m. Doesn't matter, m's 1 anyway. I think it's, yeah, divided by m. Well, m is 1, so it's just going to go away anyway. And if I made a mistake on that formula, I'll correct it in the lab book. D. That's the number we figured out, the lines, the distance, so 1 over the lines per meter, so it's a very small number. And our theta, we figured out right here, and so we take the sine of it. That's why it's useful to just keep it in radians when you do all your math, because you don't have to convert back and forth. So, we have lambda equals d sine theta. All right, now we have our lambda. For example, red, like you did in the diffraction lab, came out to 650 nanometers, or 650 times 10 to the negative 9 meters. If you don't get numbers like that for red, you've done something horribly wrong. It will probably necessitate you going back to grammar school. All right. Well, sorry, that's the way it works.
But grammar doesn't, isn't the same as math.
Yes, it isn't, but I'm getting thirsty. All right, so now we have our wavelengths. Now, how do we get from our wavelengths to energy? Now we use the equation that gives you the energy of each photon. Well, let's leave it there. That E equals hc over lambda. H is Planck's constant. C is the speed of light. Lambda is the number you figured out. All right, that will give you the energy in joules. All right, and those numbers, the Planck's constant and everything, will be in the lab manual. Is that enough? No, we're almost done though. Now I also want you to figure out the energy in a different way. And that's using this formula. And this will also be in here. I gotta write it. 13.6. Make sure I get this right. 1. What is N? Do you remember, Connor?
I just remember it has to do with the color.
Right. N was 1, I think. Let me take a look. Just take a quick look here. Either way, it'll be on there. No, N is 3. Cyan is 4. Blue is 5. And violet is 6. Here, 6. All right. So you can figure out the energy for each of these. You can even do that before class. Problem is, that's in not in joules. That's in electron volts. So you have to multiply by, I think it's 1.6 times 10 to the negative 19. Again, that number will be in the lab manual too. And then you figure out your percent differences, and then you're done. Okay, so what are the biggest problems that people have in this lab? One is they don't figure out their D's right. That's probably a big one. And you can see that because if, for example, when you go to make up your scales and chart, if all you see is all those little tick marks all scrunched over on one side like Connor did, well, that's because he figured out his D's wrong. So, and I'll tell you right now that the D's should be, so where'd you guys get? Because they all should be around the same number. They're gonna be different depending on which one you get, which one of these diffraction gratings you get. But your D value should be somewhere around 2 times 10 to the negative 6, okay? If it isn't, you're gonna have problems. Another thing is to make sure that you measure this in centimeters. Okay? The Y, when it first comes out, is in meters, then it gets changed to centimeters. Alright? What other problems do people have in this lab? You gotta make sure that the light's on. If the light's off, it's not gonna work. And then when you're all done, I can't think of anything else. Can you think of anything else?
Measuring from the slit.
Measure from the slit when you're trying to measure the for the thetas that you're going to need. And when you're all done, I'm going to give you one of these. Probably this one, because I only have one. And I'm going to tell you to look at it, at the light, and look at your light. And what you'll be able to see is see the same things, and you'll be able to read the numbers off, and you'll get the same thing. So you just built one of these without the plastic. So you saved the environment.
But then there's the paper.
And trees grow back. So, build your own spectrometers. Don't settle for these cheap plastic imitations. All right? And I will see you in the physics lab. And you turn it off.
Which button?
The red one.